three great alliances fight to claim it. Evil awakens. A long-vanished foe stirs. Those who would destroy Tamriel seek out dangers to their dark plot. And so death's long arm reaches out.
It is the 582nd year of the Second Era. The drums of war are sounding.
This is where our journey begins.
Back by now. Captain Alhanna said they'd meet us
That's
here
what she said,
after an
but
evening
I don't
of prayer,
them.
Right?
Maybe what the traveling merchant said is true.
Are you heading to the shrine?
The shrine to the goddess Kain. We come here to pray and ask for her blessing before battle. The rest of our brigade went to visit the shrine yesterday. They haven't returned yet, and I'm worried about them. Well, no. Not after that traveling merchant came by and told us that terrible story. He said dark witches had killed the keepers of the shrine. The place has been overrun. I can match steel with any soldier, but how do you battle a witch's hex? Kain bless you, stranger. Captain Alhanna commands the brigade. She's an excellent leader and a terror with a blade, but they should have been back by now. Kain is the warrior goddess, the mother of the Nord people. She watches over us and protects us. She blesses our weapons and armor before we enter battle. I wouldn't expect you to understand. Haven't you heard? The seeds of war have been planted in Eastmarch. Most of our fellow Nords are already on the battlefield. If we had the numbers, we'd march right in and take back the shrine. But as you can see, it's just Ilolda and me. Soldiers often visit the shrine before going into battle. How else would we receive Kain's blessing? The keepers provide shelter, allowing pilgrims to pray for a day and a night. But Alhanna and the others have been gone longer than that. I don't think so. Captain Alhanna is a stickler for schedules and protocols. But ever since that traveling merchant told us tales of witches and corruption at the shrine, we've been too, well, too frightened to go and check on them.
I thought the tale the traveling merchant told us was just a story. But with all the chaos, it's hard to know what to believe anymore.
Well, he said that evil witches sacrificed the keepers at the shrine. Used some unholy ritual to turn them inside out! Damn them for cursing our shrine and our goddess! We won't stand for it! But we don't want our insides on the outside either. Oh, don't get so high and mighty with me! We're just simple soldiers! If these evil witches could corrupt Kain and her shrine, what chance would we have against them? Absolutely none, that's what.
Hmm.
Night Witch! Don't curse any more of my soldiers! If you don't leave, you'll taste my blade! Krollold? Really? How do I know you didn't bewitch him, just like the others? That's the most rational thing I've... My apologies, but these are dangerous times. I watched my soldiers turn into mindless slaves. I had to make sure that your will was still your own. Our brigade came to the shrine to pray. That's when they fell upon us, Daedric witches! They bewitched most of my soldiers. We four are all that remains, and Droy is burning with an unnatural fever. I fear he won't last much longer. He was cursed by the witches. The fever burns away all that he is. Soon he'll be a mindless slave, just like the others. The Keepers could heal him, but we haven't seen a Keeper since we arrived. It's likely the witches killed or cursed them. Of course, they could be barricaded away, just like we are, waiting for help to arrive. Droy mentioned something about them before the fever took him, but we've had other things to deal with. Explore the shrine. The witches there might have a clue. There's also a locked dresser by the bed. One of the bewitched soldiers might have a key. I'd love to know what they've locked in there. Before the fever took Droy, he mentioned the witch by the lake. He said she didn't attack him. Find this witch. If she's really willing to talk to you, she might have something useful to say.
Droy's fever grows worse. A fever curse grips poor Droy. If we don't cure him soon, I fear he'll become one of the bewitched. Droy was sent to the shrine ahead of the brigade to let the Keepers know we were coming and give them time to prepare. When we arrived, we found Droy like this, burning with fever. I've been trying to care for him, but nothing seems to help. There's one thing I haven't tried yet. There's a flower that's been known to cure a fever. It's called Kine's Breath. It grows around the runestones that decorate the grove. A handful may help save Droy's life. Can you get some for me?
Find out!
Thank you.
I smell fresh kine's breath. It reminds me when I was a little girl running through the fields in spring. I miss those simpler days. Oh, yes. This is more than enough. The flower is very potent. Thank you. With these, I should be able to reduce Droy's fever. Droy's fate is in Kine's hands, but his chances are better now. I'll continue to watch over him until he wakes up. Since he was here before us, it's possible that Droy knows what happened to the Keepers. We need to find out what he saw.
Split up! I don't see a way farther into the sanctuary. Perhaps you'll have better luck. No, that doesn't seem helpful. That's dragon bone powder. The ancient dragon guard used it in their ceremonies. Of course. The powder reveals a hidden path. Follow it, quickly! Another archive. No dragonhorn in sight. Let's look around. Have you found something? Did you find anything? Something about the Dragonhorn? By Leki's blade! Of all the possibilities I imagined, that was never among them. No matter the dangers, we must retrieve that Dragonhorn. The fate of Elsewhere depends on it. Did the journal indicate where Veloxen lairs? Such a journey requires planning and preparation. Let's return to the Abbey of Blades and check in with Kasura.